Hey y'all, it's Dora. I'm so glad you dropped by because I have this really fun project. With Christmas right around the corner, I've been wanting to do something with ornaments. So today's tutorial is about bubble bar ornaments. And if you don't know what bubble bars are, they're essentially bubble bath in the form of a bar. For fragrance, I chose Caribbean teakwood, mahogany coconut, and a bit of birch and black pepper. It's a Christmas scent, but like a stylish Christmas scent, if that makes sense. I'm not that fond of Christmas tree. It's just a bit too strong of pine for me. Always add mica powder to wet ingredients so they don't become airborne. I'm doing blue with silver ornaments, but originally planned on doing also red with gold ornaments. I bring this up because if you want to do multiple colors, make the dough as usual minus the color. Then once the dough is formed, you can divide it, and at that point you can add powder and or liquid color to each. I really thought I was gonna need my mixer for this, I normally do. But I guess for this small batch, it wasn't necessary. You just add the wet ingredients, stir it around just well enough, and then get in there with your hands. At first, it's very sticky, but then almost instantly, the dough starts pulling itself together. It takes maybe 2 minutes to get a ball this size. This dough can be fussy. It can easily be too wet and stick to everything. Also, if you add too much cornstarch, it can easily dry out and then crumble to pieces. Just make sure that you have parchment or wax paper down. Add a small amount of cornstarch to the surface and your rolling pin. Then roll the dough out to desired thickness and then cut out the shapes. Any leftover dough can be re-rolled and used to cut out more ornaments. You may end up with a small piece left over. I just used it for my bath that night. Make sure to cure these ornaments at least 24 hours before you start painting them or fondling them or just moving them in general. Just leave them on the table unwrapped. Whenever you're trying new techniques or colors or painting, always start with the ugliest bar first, then work your way up. You don't want to practice on your pretty ones, and you only get better as you practice. You can also paint designs in a very light color, and then once satisfied, go back in with darker colors. That's not what I was doing here. I really just wanted that sparkly blue mica, but it was too light. But this is definitely an option if you're unsure about a specific design that you want to try out. Don't forget to paint the top of the ornament. I'm not sure of the technical name for this or if there even is one, but this is such an easy design to paint and I feel like it really adds to the overall look of the ornament. I shrink wrapped these ornaments 2 to a pack and they package so nicely. The sparkling ornaments face out and you can even poke a little hole at the top and tie them together with a big fancy bow. I can see myself hanging them on the tree, handing them out as Christmas gifts to my family, giving them to my friends, and even giving my son's teacher one. Endless options here. That's all in my head, of course. In reality, my greedy butt has already used them all. But I guess I'll just have to make more for sure. Anyway, those were the trial and error ones, so I don't feel that bad. I'm essentially giving you a few basic design options here so that you can get an idea for your own ornament design. And by the way, if you make this ornament, I would love to see pictures. So this bubble bar really outdid itself. It exceeded my expectations for sure. I used just half a bar and it filled my tub with bubbles that went over the rim of the tub. And it was those quality bubbles that you could pick up and build with, or, well, maybe stack is a better word. Anyways, the water also turned a light blue, which is always fun, and the bubbles themselves smelt amazing. Like, the whole bathroom smelt amazing. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you found it helpful or inspirational, you should subscribe. Don't miss out on weekly creative bath videos and ideas.